Welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Aparna, working as scientist in MFPI Quality Control Laboratory, Professor Jaishankar, Telangana State Agricultural University, Hyderabad. Today, we are going to learn about the processing and preservation by non-thermal food processing methods. Food processing procedures like cooking, blanching, or freezing are very familiar to the consumers because they apply these kinds of procedures in their regular household food processing techniques. In the food industry, these and other operations are carried out by aid of modern processing technology plants utilizing technical possibilities that are normally not available at the consumer level. Modern food technology, on one hand, deals with further development of traditional methods. For example, high temperature, short time processing methods, then vacuum cooking, and on the other hand, it also deals with procedures that have been taken over from various kinds of advanced food industry applications. And these applications have been adapted to the food processing sector. For example, extrusion technology, microwave technology, high pressure treatment, etc. Newly developed food technologies usually focus on preservation while keeping the food quality attributes intact. Although thermal preservation provides safer food, there exists loss of food quality attributes, especially the sensory properties as well as the nutritional properties are lost to a considerable extent in the thermal processing techniques. The thermal processing techniques like canning, heating, dehydration, etc. And the main objective of the new techniques is to retain the nutrient quantities as well as the sensory parameters of any kind of foods, and also to increase the shelf life of the food without any adverse effect on the quality attributes. And these kinds of requirements have paved way for the non-thermal processing techniques. Then apart from these objectives, the other objectives of preservation, that is to increase the shelf life by reducing the microbial load and also by reducing the water activity. Now both of these can be achieved by either traditional method of preservation or by non-thermal processing techniques like microwave heating, pulsed electric field technology, high pressure processing, pulsed light technology, ohmic heating, irradiation, ultrasonication, pulsed X-rays, oscillating magnetic fields, etc. The selection of particular preservation method for the particular food product is based on the criteria like cost of production, scale of production, type of product, either milk, meat, poultry, fruit, vegetable, or shelf life and end product usage, that is either ready to eat or ready to cook product. The non-thermal techniques are recently used for all the food products for shelf life extension. Now let us know about what are the objectives of these non-thermal food processing technologies. The objectives of non-thermal food processing are to render food which is free from pathogenic as well as spoilage microorganisms. The other objective is to retain the maximum amount of color and flavor in the food matrices. Then the next objective is to improve the shelf life of the food material. Then the last objective is also to improve and retain the textural attributes of the food matrices. Non-thermal food processing techniques are more suitable for liquid foods than the solid and semi-solid foods, and also for processing of ready-to-cook packed foods. It is also reviewed that uniform distribution of heat is not achieved in processing of solid foods using the new trends in food processing. Investment cost of new methods of food processing is very expensive. It's quite high and it can be applied to large scale industries when compared to small scale industries. The better quality is achieved in non-thermal processing and its shelf life is also increased by application of the non-thermal processing techniques. Coming to the first non-thermal processing technique, that is ohmic heating. Ohmic heating is a thermal method that minimizes temperature equipped with several electrodes. The advantage of ohmic heating is its ability to heat materials rapidly and uniformly, including products containing particulates. The principal mechanism of microbial inactivation in ohmic heating are thermal, while some evidence exists for non-thermal effect of ohmic heating as well because of very low temperature due to the electric passage of the food. A large number of potential future applications exist for ohmic heating, including its use in blanching, evaporation, dehydration, fermentation, and extraction. Ohmic heating is employed in pasteurizing and sterilizing of liquid and particulate foods, especially for ready-to-serve meals, fruits, vegetables, meat, poultry or fish products, and is also an alternative to sterilization of foods by means of conventional heat exchangers or autoclaves. The applicability of ohmic heating is limited to thermal conductivity of the foods because electricity has to be passed into the food. Then we have the second category of non-thermal food processing, that is high electric field pulses. The first attempts to treat food with electro impulses were reported at end of the 1920s in the United States of America. Further experiments followed in the 1960s, primarily within molecular biological research for incorporation of foreign gene material into microorganisms. During the last few years, research in the food area has been reinforced again. High-intensity pulsed electric field processing involves the application of pulses of high voltage, typically 20 to 80 kilovolts, to foods placed between two electrodes. High-intensity pulsed electric applications may be applied in form of exponentially decaying, square wave, bipolar or oscillatory pulses, and at ambient, subambient or slightly above ambient temperatures for less than 1 second. Energy lost due to heating of foods is minimized, reducing the detrimental changes of sensory and physical properties of the foods. Microbial inactivation also can be achieved by high-intensity pulsed electric field application, and this has been explained by several theories. The most studied possibilities are electrical breakdown and electroporation. Electric high voltage impulses generate a transmembrane potential across the cell membrane, for example, for a bacterial cell wall, which overlays the natural membrane potential. If the difference between outer and inner membrane potential rises above a critical value of about 1 volt, then you can see that polarization and in end breakdown of the membrane is induced. At sufficient high field strength, about 10 kilovolts, and duration of pulses usually between nano and microseconds, vegetative microorganisms in liquid media are always inactivated due to irreversible membrane destruction. Bacterial spores, however, are not inactivated. Factors that affect the microbial inactivation with high-intensity pulsed electric field are process factors, that is, the electric field intensity, pulse width, treatment time, temperature, and pulse wave shapes. Microbial entity factors like type, concentration, growth stage of microorganism, and media factors like pH, antimicrobials, and ionic compounds, conductivity, and medium ionic strength. These are the factors. So the factors are broadly categorized as process factors, microbial entity factors, and media factors. These important aspects in pulsed electric field technology are generation of high electric field intensities, the design of chambers which impart uniform treatment to the foods with a minimum increase in temperature, and the design of electrodes that minimize the effect of electrolysis. Different laboratory and pilot scale treatment chambers have been designed and used for high intensity pulsed electric field application for various foods. application of high intensity pulsed electric field is restricted to food products that can withstand high electrical fields, that is, if they have low electrical conductivity and do not contain or form bubbles. The particle size of the liquid food in both static and flow treatment modes is also a limitation to this technology. Although high intensity pulsed electric field application is a potential technology for food preservation, the existing system and experimental conditions are diverse, and conclusions about the effects of critical process factors on the pathogens of concern and kinetics of inactivation need to be further studied to make sure that this technology can be adapted by the food processing sector. Based on the practical experience from pilot plants, employment of the high-intensity pulsed electric field will mainly be in the sparing pasteurization of liquid foods, for example, fruit juices, milk, liquid whole eggs, etc. Conclusive data on the absence of potential health risks or on the impact of process on food components are hardly available with respect to this technology. Then we have the third non-thermal food processing technology, that is light pulses. Pulsed light is a method of food preservation that involves the use of intense and short duration pulses of broad spectrum white light, which is ultraviolet or near infrared region lights. For most applications, few flashes applied in a fraction of a second provide a high level of microbial inactivation in some kinds of foods. This technology is applicable mainly in sterilizing or reducing the microbial population on packaging or food surfaces. It could be shown that light impulses are able to extend the durability of the bread, cakes, and pastries apart from some kinds of seafood and meat products. As light pulses penetrate certain packaging materials, wrapped items also can be traced. Still, there is need of independent research on the inactivation kinetics of the light pulses in full spectrum of representative variables in different kinds of food systems for the technology to be applied on a larger scale. Then we have the next technology in non-thermal processing, that is oscillating magnetic fields. Coming to the next technology, that is oscillating magnetic fields, experiments have shown that strong static or oscillating magnetic fields with 5 to 50 Tesla have energy input and thus reduces thermal damage to the food. If an electric current is passing through a conductive medium, in this case the food, the medium warms up as a result of the movement of the ions. The conductive electric resistance heating, ohmic heating, utilizes the effect of electrical resistance within a conductive liquid or solid material. In this manner, a direct conversion of electric energy into heat takes place. In production plants, the product is continuously pumped through a column, potential to inactivate vegetative microorganisms. The impulse duration is between 10 milliseconds to several milliseconds. The frequencies are maximally 500 megahertz because above that value, the items begin to warm up noticeably. Preservation of foods with oscillating magnetic fields involves sealing foods in a plastic bag and subjecting it to 1 to 100 pulses in the oscillating magnetic fields at a temperature of 0 to 50 degrees centigrade for a total exposure time ranging from 25 to 100 milliseconds. The effects of magnetic fields on microbial populations have produced controversial results. Before considering this technology for food preservation purposes, consistent results concerning the efficacy of methods are needed. Then we have the next non-thermal processing method, that is ultrasound. Ultrasonic waves, that is the energy which is generated by sound waves of 20,000 hertz or more. These ultrasonic waves generate gas bubbles in liquid media that produce a high temperature and pressure increase when they immediately burst. The bactericidal effect of ultrasound is attributed to intracellular cavitation, that is micromechanical shocks that disrupt cellular structural and functional components up to the point of cell lysis. Critical processing factors are the nature of ultrasonic waves, the exposure time with microorganisms, the type of microorganisms, the volume of food to be processed, the composition of the food, and the temperature. The effects, however, are not severe enough for a sufficient reduction of microorganisms, so most applications use a combination with other preservation methods. Because of the complexity and sometimes protective nature of the food, the singular use of ultrasound as a preservation method is impracticable. Although ultrasound technology has a wide range of current and future applications in the food industry, including inactivation of microorganisms and enzymes, presently most development for food applications are non-microbial applications only. There are not many research data on inactivation of food microorganisms by ultrasound. Research activities centered on combination of ultrasound with other preservation processes, that is heat treatment or mild heat treatment or mild pressure, can appear to have greatest potential for industrial application. So ultrasonication along with a combination of other technologies can be suitable for reduction in the microbial load in any kind of food matrices. Then we have the sixth non-thermal processing technology, that is high pressure processing. The technology of high pressure processing, also referred to as ultra high pressure or high hydrostatic pressure, has been known to be a potential preservation technique for more than a century. For instance, microbial spoilage of milk could be delayed by high pressure. Technical scientific progress has led to a renaissance of food pasteurization by high hydrostatic pressure very recently. A range of pressure treated products has already been introduced into the markets of Japan, France, Spain, USA. High pressure processing subjects liquid and solid foods with and without packaging to pressures between 1000 to 800 megapascals. Process temperatures during pressure treatment can be between 0 degrees centigrade to above 100 degrees centigrade. Exposure times can range from few seconds to over 20 minutes. Food treated in this way has been shown to keep its original freshness, color, flavor, and taste. High pressure processing acts instantaneously and uniformly throughout a mass of food independent of size, shape, and food composition. Compression will increase the temperature of the foods approximately 3 degrees centigrade per 100 megapascal and may also shift the pH of the food as a function of imposed pressure. Pressure pasteurization is feasible also at room temperature and energy saving as compared to heat treatment. Water activity and pH are critical process factors in the inactivation of microbes by high pressure processing. An increase in food temperature above the room temperature and to a lesser extent a decrease below room temperature in some cases increase the inactivation of rate of microorganisms during high pressure processing treatment. Temperatures in the range of 45 to 50 degrees centigrade appear to increase the rate of inactivation of food pathogens and spoilage microbes. Temperatures ranging from 90 to 110 degrees centigrade in conjunction with pressures of 500 to 700 megapascals have been used to inactivate spore-forming bacteria such as Clostridium botulinum. Current pressure processes include batch and semi-continuous systems. Besides destruction of microorganisms, there are further influences of pressure on food materials to be expected. They are protein denaturation or modification, enzyme activation or inactivation, changes in enzyme-substrate interactions, changes in the properties of polymer carbohydrates and fats. Generally, any process and any reaction in the food to which the principle of Le Chatelier applies are of interest. According to this principle, under equilibrium conditions, a process associated with decrease in volume is favored by pressure and vice versa. An increase of pressure has been found to change the reaction rate of chemical reactions in solutions. But this effect is small as compared to the influence of temperature. The renewed interest in high-pressure pasteurization of food has raised questions on pressure-temperature behavior of macromolecular components of the food, like proteins, lipids, polysaccharides, etc. For example, the mechanism of protein gelation and of the sol-gel behavior of polysaccharides are not well understood. Little is known so far about the chemical reactions of low molecular weight compounds in the food matrix under pressure, usually in aqueous media. High pressure, on the other hand, has for a long time been a means of manipulating organic chemical reactions. High pressure influences organic reactions in general. So, at pressures greater than 500 megapascals, which are employed for food sterilization, chemical reactions in the food are to be expected, which may be of desirable character. Among all the non-thermal processing technologies, high-pressure processing technology has got many applications in fruit, vegetable, meat, seafood and other applications also. And this is being industrially promoted as compared to the other non-thermal processing techniques. So, to get an overview of all these non-thermal processing techniques, we will first start with the ultraviolet light and pulsed light techniques as well as the ultrasound techniques. Now, these processes where utilization of ultraviolet radiation exposure at least 400 joules per meter square and intense and short duration pulses of broad spectrum are used. Then apart from that, for ultrasound, the energy which is generated by sound waves of more than 20,000 hertz or more is being utilized. Now, the critical factors for these technologies is about the transmissivity of the product, the geometry, the power, wavelength and arrangement of the light sources of the product, and also the flow profile is the critical factor to be taken care of. In ultrasound, the heterogeneous and protective nature of the food, that is example of particulates, they severely curtail the singular use of ultrasound for preparation. Therefore, a combination of techniques for ultrasound processing technique has to be used to make sure the maximum benefit is obtained for reduction of the microbial load in the foods. Then coming to the mechanism of inactivation, the ultraviolet rays and the light pulses, they will create DNA mutations which are induced by the DNA absorption of the UV light. Whereas in the ultrasound, intercellular cavitation, that is because of the micromechanical shocks that disrupt the cellular structural and functional components, will lead to cell lysis and thereby reduction in the microorganisms. Coming to the status of these technologies and their application in the food processing sector, the ultraviolet light pulses and ultrasound are used for disinfection of water supplies and food contact surfaces. Then the ultrasound is used along with a combination of other processing technologies like heat, pressure, and then only the potential of ultrasound can be felt in the food processing sector. Then coming to the second category of the non-thermal processing techniques, that is oscillating magnetic field technique. Oscillating magnetic field technique, here the food is subjected in plastic bags to 1 to 100 OMF, that is oscillating magnetic field pulses, at 0 to 5 degrees centigrade for 25 to 100 microseconds. Here you see that the consistent results are obtained concerning the efficacy of this method, and more applications are required to confirm the results. Then you can see that there are controversial results on the effects of magnetic fields on the microbial populations also, which needs further study. Coming to the status of the OMF application, at the moment it is not considered in many of the food processing sectors. It is still under research and needs more information for application in the food processing sector. Then we have the pulsed electric field. Here you see that high voltage pulses are applied to the foods between two electrodes, and you see that this application is taken care at ambient temperature. The electric field intensity, the pulse width, treatment, time, temperature, pulse wave, shapes, type, concentration, growth stage of microorganisms, pH, antimicrobials, conductivity, and medium ionic strength all have to be taken care of while application of the pulsed electric field for preservation of the foods. The most theories which are studied, they are talking about the electric breakdown and the electroporation. Different laboratory and pilot scale treatments are therefore required, and the chambers have to be designed and used for foods only to industrial scale, and there are very few pulsed electric field systems available all over the world for food processing sector. Then we have the most extensively used non-thermal processing technology, that is high pressure processing. Here, the liquid or solid foods with or without packaging is subjected to 100 to 800 megapascals below 0 degrees to 100 degrees centigrade from a few seconds to over 20 minutes. And here you see that instantaneously and uniformly throughout a mass of the food, independent of size, shape and food composition, the desired effect is achieved. The pressure, time at temperature, time at pressure, including the adiabatic heating, pH and composition are critical factors which are to be considered. Denaturation of enzymes, proteins, breakdown of biological membranes and cellular mass transfer are affected in the food matrix. Coming to the status of high pressure processing, it is in use since 1990 in countries like Japan, USA, France, Spain, etc. Current pressure processes include batch and semi-continuous systems. And high pressure processing, among all the non-thermal processing techniques, is extensively applicable in all the food processing sectors. Coming to the conclusion of this topic, the main problem with the thermal processing of food is loss of volatile compounds, nutrients, and also the sensory parameters like flavor. To overcome these problems, non-thermal processing techniques have come into food industries to increase the production rate and profitability by retaining the nutrient and sensory properties of the food. The non-thermal processing is used for all foods for its better quality, acceptance, and also for the shelf life. The new processing techniques are mostly employed to the liquid packaged foods when compared to solid foods. Since the non-thermal methods are used for bulk quantities of the food, these methods of food preservation are mainly used in large-scale production. The cost of equipment used in the non-thermal processing is very, very high when compared to the equipments used in the thermal processing. After minimizing the investment cost of non-thermal processing methods, it can be employed in small-scale industries. After thorough study of certain non-thermal processing techniques, the application can go in a big way. Thank you.